Right, so this is tips 42 for Rogue Galaxy. It's going to be a bit of a short one because this is the rare enemies for Ghouls of Sanctuary, which is the second to last dungeon in the game. But after I'd gone into Mother's Lair, touched all of the save points and got the locations of the chests up, I went round and collected all the chests and enemies that I need for Ghouls of Sanctuary are pretty hardly anything. Manticore, only two of those. They turn up in fours and twos anyway, so I just need a battle with those. Ice Eaters, need two of those. I know exactly where to go for those, and they turn up in twos, so one more fight, basically. I'll just show you where to go for the Ice Eaters. Manticore sort of turn up randomly everywhere. The Ice Eaters turn up in the blue section of the plaza. That's, I think it's Jupiter's. It's either Jupiter's or Steve's Dragalum. And it's the one next to the path going towards Mother's Lair. So I'll just show you. I might even be able to get in. I always get a bit messed up trying to go down. Yeah, trying to get down the path a bit harder. I've also managed to master quite a lot of the weapons as well. I've got all of the seven swords mastered. Nearly all of my allies are mastered as well. So, and if they're not mastered by the time I get through Mother's Lair, I've got a ton of Exalian shards and Omega crystals, Hyper crystals. Make stars rather to sort that out, so no problem there. Everything's going to be mastered by the time I finish this game. Babels, yeah, a bit of a pain. Now, I seem to remember Manticore's turning up sort of as you come up to Ghouls of Sanctuary and also away from it. I managed to get a fight going towards Mother's Lair as well, so they're kind of a bit random really. I've had them in the plaza as well, so actually in the plaza, so... So blue is where you need to be, and this is where you'll find most of the Ice Eaters if you're having a problem. There you go, look, immediately. So really good place for Ice Eaters if you're hanging out for those. I remember I seem to have a problem with blizzards before now as well, in another time when I've gone through this game, but this is another great place for blizzards as well. Blizzards and Ice Eaters. And blizzards sort of turn up in fours anyway, so once you find the right place, it will take no time to get those. The amount of enemies really, and then start jumping around to get the giants, but The only thing else I can sort of add to this area is that if you're looking for crystal staffs, you're looking at, I'll just show you the creatures that drop those. Luminous. Sort of more than anything else, I've been getting them off those. In Mother's Lair, Faces of Evil seem to drop them quite a lot as well. There's also a chest on the way to Mother's Lair on the map. So from the plaza there to Mother's Lair, there's a chest up there with two of them in for the crystal staffs. So the only thing, I think I need just one more crystal staff, and I need the rest is galactic compasses, but that's it. I can get those in bits. Just kind of hoping to get a manticore there. Seem to remember manticore is one of the first. Pathways that I went on, just go. So I was going to make this quite a quick one, but I've gone into rambling mode now, so. Let's see if I can get a mantle. Just a luminous. Let's see if it drops a crystal staff. The other rare drop. Ah, perfect. That's awesome. Alright, yeah. So I'm nearly done with the crystal staffs in my revelation chart, actually. So it's an Indigo needs. I'm not actually sure if he needs another one. Let's just have a look. So he's got a tank level 3. There's a galactic compass there. So yeah, that was the only one I needed. So it's just galactic compasses, and I'm nearly done with the revelation charts. Let's go up this one here. I'm pretty sure I saw a manticore up here. You might get a bit unlucky and run into a bunch of devils. They are a bit of a pain. So you need to have that gun, the barrier gun sort of equipped all the time. There you go, look, devils. Reducing the numbers of enemies, really, to begin with, and then a bit of crowd control. I'm hoping this is a manticore region. Let's have a look. If not in the next five, if not in the next sort of three seconds, I might go back to beginning of Ghoul's Sanctuary, so from TF Forest to Ghoul's Sanctuary, because I'm pretty sure they turn up there quite a lot. This is the path from Teatha Forest up to Ghoul's Sanctuary, just by the little shop, two manticores, so this is a really good place for them. Let me just kill them. Quite easy to kill. And that should be it. That should be everything for Ghoul's Mother Sanctuary. So it is basically go to Mother's Lair, touch all of the save points. I've done a full walkthrough for that as well, so if you want to have a look at that, I would say if you're not going to bother doing the walkthrough, just sort of go the opposite way from the arrows and you should really hit most parts of that dungeon. It's quite a large dungeon, but as you can see, Manticore's done and everything else is also complete. Well, Alucard and Face of Evil are Mother's Lair anyway, so the only things I need to get now is Deimos, which is 2, so not a problem. Dragon and Togroth, I know a place for those. Platinum Kite are a bit tricky. And Hell Sorcerer, so I'll find some good places for those, but that's Mother's Lair, so that is the last dungeon in the game. So once I've got those, we should have about sort of like 85% of the hunting record done. And these, you may wonder, so we've got from 57 to 200, so we've got 43 beasts there that we need to kill, and they're in a secret dungeon, but I'll take you through that as well, because I know experience where to get the other rare creatures. There's rare creatures in that dungeon as well. Yeah, I think you've been left off the hook, but you haven't been. But the next sort of tips I'll be doing will be showing you the reward for getting the revelation chart, because the only thing I need to get now is galactic compasses. I'm maxed out on my crystal staffs, and galactic compasses are the only thing left to get now, and they are dropped as a rare drop from bits. But also I haven't opened the chest in Mother's Lair yet, so it's possible I'll pick up a few from some chests there. So crystal staff, not that time. No, I don't need one anyway. I've gone just about